how is it seeing them transformed onto the screen then?
It's sort of extraordinary. I still can't quite get over the fact that I am now sitting next to Alex Rider, a character I've lived with for 20 years, and now suddenly here he is played by Otto and played to perfection. I could not be happier. As to Brennock, who you saw briefly on the video, in the books, as anybody who's read them knows, Tom is a tiny character, but Brennock is so spectacularly good in the part that the character is almost equal to Alex. I mean, the scenes when the two of them are together are such fun, there's so much energy, that now when I'm writing the books, actually Tom is almost as big a character as Alex.
Did it feel like you, when you first saw Otto, was there a bit of a moment where you're just like, that's the guy?
Well, I'll tell you something. In that, you know, you talked about the casting process, and I remember that all these actors were finally down to about 18 or 20 people who were doing Jack and Tom and Alex and different versions of them. And the moment that Ronke and Brennock and Alex came together, every single person in the room, every suit, every person there involved knew we had our cast. It was something magic happened, and you'll see it on the screen. I didn't write the screenplay to this series. I was busy working on the next Alex Rider novel, Nightshade, out next year, just thought I'd mention it. so I passed writing duties over to Guy, and he took over, and I can't tell you how excited I am by the fact that he's been so true to the spirit of Point Blank and of the characters and the plot and everything, but has really made it his own and expanded the world and made it more adult and darker, and in some ways even, I think, more intense than the book. He just did a great job, but I didn't. It's not...
thank you.
Well, I would say that, wouldn't I? If I had all these people, talk to you later.
Do you find it easy to hand over your characters for someone else to kind of run away with a little
bit? Yeah, television is about collaboration. If you don't trust the team, and I was lucky because 11th Hour Films gave me the dream team. If you don't trust the team, you're just going to, you know, you're going to do yourself no good. So I was happy to take a back seat. I kept watch on everything, but I didn't really get involved. I didn't need to. The truth is that when I wrote the Alex Rider books, they were always said to be adult books for kids. They were never really meant to be sort of ordinary children's books. And it was very important for the TV show. We all agreed from the start that this was not going to be children's television. It was a difficult balancing act because we had to appeal to a wide adult audience whilst at the same time not alienating younger viewers by being too violent, too adult, too serious or whatever. I didn't particularly get involved. In fact, if I may say so, it's probably Andreas who should answer that question, because the moment Andreas came into the picture, he completely understood the tone, which was this not even family drama, but, you know, but serious adult drama that would still appeal to kids.
In my head, season three is mapped out.
Season three?
Yeah, because I need to know that in order to think about season two. Because you need to know where you're finishing season two in order to kick that off. So I'm ridiculously ahead of the curve here and, you know, quite happy, enjoying it.
We were talking about, you know, what we're going to do with these characters and having got so many fantastic actors, how we're going to give them interesting things to do in the next season and the one after. That's absolutely right. Two and three, which I think are going to be fairly closely tied together, are already underway in Guy's head, which is great.
With this trailer, Stormbreaker seems to have been cut completely. Is that coming back in a later season, or was the movie so bland that it traumatized that book forever?
Well...
Why don't you get... Don't sit on the fence, mate, whatever you do.
Look, The film was what the film was, but the fact is it was made and we moved on from it. So we start with Point Blank as being the first in this TV series. And you will see in the series that some elements, the origin elements of Ian Ryder's death and how Alex becomes a spy, have been built into this. But, you know, that was then. That was a 9-year-old film, and it was made for a slightly different, probably a more American audience. I'm thrilled with what we've done this time round. This is a show, actually, that I wish the film had been.
I think it's safe to say it looks the opposite of bland. I think we can all agree on that. Thank you very much for your question, though. God bless you, son. Over to you.
To see the power of five on the screen, you know, I'm waiting. Any producers in the hall, come and talk to me afterwards. I mean, yeah, I think that it's interesting that the show has... The books, I think, have got darker and darker as they've gone on. And what I like about the show is, although it is quite dark, it hasn't lost sight of the fact that it's still meant to be entertaining and has its cheerful moments. But in answer to your question, yeah, sure, I'd love to see the point of the power of five, and for that matter, some of my other books on the screen. I live in hope.
All of them, right, Anthony? Every single
well,
one.
Well, whatever, you know. Can I say how much more I liked your question than the first one? Thanks.
You're welcome. Cheers.
In terms of the future life of this series, of course, look, there are 14 Alex Rider books. That could be 14 more years of Alex on TV. At the end of the day, that decision is really down to you, to the audience. If you like this show, if it does well, we'll be back. But it's encouraging that, you know, the people who've seen it so far have been really positive, and that Guy and I are already commissioned to be writing and working on the next season. So that's a good sign. Yasin's here somewhere. Isn't Yasin in the audience too? Do we have a crazy Russian assassin somewhere in the building?
Somewhere.
Maybe.
Stand
keeping,
up if
keeping
you're there.
They've gone after that other lad.
Yeah. Keeping a low profile, as Yasin would. You'll see, Guy's worked it out really cleverly, that Yasin, although he originally appears in Stormbreaker, he comes now into Point Blank and repeats his role there, and is going to become, I think, a really interesting and dark and serious character in the series moving forward.
He's one of my favourite characters, so he's definitely in.
Definitely there. If you look around, they might be watching you right now.
I like all of them.
which was the easiest to write? Are any of them easy to write?
I never use easy and difficult as talking about writing, because I think that if it's difficult, something's gone wrong. Writing should flow. Writing should be energy and passion. And the moment you start feeling you're knotted and tied up and it's not coming, I stop. So, in answer to your question, Sydney, I love Russian Roulette. It's one of my very favorites because I'm so fascinated by Yasin and by the evil guy. But no, easy, difficult, I don't do.
Fine.
I love the Alex Rider books, so I wanted to say that.
Thank you.
My question is about the show being more grounded in reality. Eventually, Alex Rider does get into some pretty surreal situations, like he ends up in space. Could we expect to eventually see that on TV?
Archangel, book number 6, sends Alex into space. I did a lot of research for it. Funnily enough, you would do much better in outer space than your dad would, because young people have more flexible bones and muscles and will survive better out there, apparently. I think that if we get that far, and if Guy doesn't cut it, he'll go to space, yeah.
Is that what you want to see?
Yeah.
Good, awesome. Good.
Sony, are you listening?
It's got something for everybody, that's the whole thing. As to it, the big screen, I'm very happy being on this screen, on the TV screen. All the most exciting drama, in my view, is happening right now on the S-boxes, on TV. That's where all the action is. And, you know, this is exactly the film, the TV series, that I really wanted to see out of my book. So it's here and it's for everyone.